Hey guys, AJ here, back with another one. So today we're going to look at some red pill moments from Judge Judy. Now, I never really watched Judge Judy, but I had some respect for her after I saw her in an interview, and she said how she was never into the whole effinist, womanist type of stuff, and how she didn't really join any women's groups in college or in law school, and how she always considered herself just a judge and not a female judge or a female lawyer. She said, I'm just a judge and I get by on my own merit. So I respect that, right? So here are some moments from her show where she's actually advocating for men as fathers in her courtroom. So let's just jump into this, guys. But first, please remember to like, subscribe, drop a comment. It really helps to keep this channel going. All right, you guys, let's jump into this.
We're supposed to, in this country, treat mothers and fathers the same with regard to custody. No one has a less equal position. However, when I practiced in the family court and then was later a judge in the family court, I found that that law was honored in the breach. Most judges and most psychologists that served the court always thought that the mother was better. And I didn't always find that that was true.
Absolute facts. Women get custody 90% of the time. And the legal system, paternity court, family court just assumes that women are just better parents most of the time, and fathers get screwed over.
You have a child with him?
Yes.
That's not your child. That's both
okay,
of your
child.
No, look, just a second. That child is both of yours. So either you take the child or he takes the child. He's the father no less than you're the mother. So
you take this up with the family court judge. Your case is dismissed. We understand each other? Take it up with the family court judge. When the family court judge issues an order of support, whoever the order of support is going to be entered against. But I'm going to suggest this to the two of you. You've wisely or unwisely made a child together. You don't have the right to take the child away from the other parent.
That's a rough looking woman, guys. Oh, what? Okay, that's enough.
He would not have that right to take the child away from you. That's what the court said. And whether you like it...
So guys, in those last two clips, she is right. See, women just act like they own children. Like the children are theirs. Like they own a dog, right? And it's funny how they say that it takes two to tango when women get pregnant. But then when a divorce or a breakup, these are my kids. Instead of saying, these are our kids.
Again, or not. Whether you like her or not. Whether he's a nice guy or not. Whether he's a bum or not. He's a bum that you picked to make two children with. Mm-hmm. And if he shows up to see the children on a Wednesday, and he's given you some indication that he wasn't going to be there on Wednesday, and for no other reason than he said he wasn't going to come, you don't let your children see him, that's wrong.
Facts. Using children as weapons. Women do it all the time.
That's wrong. It's not between the two of you. He could be the biggest bum in the world. He lived with his children. His children know who he is. They have a right to see their father unless he is abusive to them, dangerous to them, which I assume that prior to 2007, you never made that allegation. Would that be a fair statement?
That would be fair.
Well, then unless he had some psychotic breakdown, which I doubt.
Well,
no, which I doubt.
See, look at the hatred that this woman has for this guy. Just look, she's so just... She just hates that guy so much. And she's like, because I perceive that you did something to me, or maybe you moved on, that means that you are a terrible person and you can't see your kids. Guys, I don't care what, just because someone does something to you, or someone does something to their spouse, let's just say that you're a guy and you cheat on your wife, doesn't make you a bad father. It doesn't. It might make you a crappy boyfriend, husband, or whatever, but it doesn't make you a bad father. And unfortunately, society tries to make those two things one and the same.
Nothing changed with regard to his love for his children from 2007 to 2009, except that you were PO'd with him.
Facts.
Now, that's unfair. Whether you like that or not, it's unfair. It's unfair for the children. Unfair to him, I don't care about. Unfair to you, I don't care about. But it's unfair for the children. And if you deny them the right to see their father, they will eventually hate you. I want you to understand that. I want you to be prepared for the fact that if you don't let your children visit meaningfully with their father, there will be a day down the road when they will hate you. Justifiably so. Do you get it? Do you get it? Justifiably so. Because you will have allowed your anger to get in the way of their relationship with their father. Good, bad, or middle of the road. That's who you picked to make them with. You don't visit your bad judgment onto your children. Do we understand each other?
I understand you. I don't agree with you at all.
I don't give a... Listen.
So she was just not listening that whole time, just in her feelings. And this is the thing about modern women. You can make up a perfectly rational argument. And look, they'll give you this look there. And you're better off talking to a brick wall. At least then you'll hear your own echo bounce back.
To make them with... You don't visit your bad judgment onto your children. Do we understand each other?
I understand you. I don't agree with you at all.
I don't give a... Listen, since I'm not adjudicating that or not, I have to tell you this. In 40 years, I've seen tens of thousands of women just like you who will invest all of their beautiful bloom time in hating the person that they made their children with. And I guarantee you this. You know what's going to happen? Eventually, you're going to drive him away.
Yep.
He's got a beautiful new fiance. And he and this beautiful new fiance will go on and make a beautiful new family. And one day he's going to say, I'm tired. I want to see my kids. I would love to see my kids. And I feel badly that I'm not seeing my kids. But she really is an SOB. And she created this problem. And when they get older, they'll see me. But I'm not going to waste my time anymore. Eventually, he's
going
to say that.
Mr. Baxter said that.
Facts. Just like Mr. Palmer says, shout out to him. Oftentimes, if you and your kid's mom, if it's too much trouble, guys, just wash your hands clean and walk away. Get that direct deposit for child support. Let it go, man. Keep your veins cold. Because you can only do so much if you have a woman like this in your life, guys, this woman right here on this screen. Think about the hell she's put this guy through. Right? Guys, just pack your stuff, walk away. You know, save up some college funds for your kids, and when they turn 18, tell them, look, I tried.
Just a second. If he said it, it's because you made it difficult. I've seen you for a very short period of time, and I know that if he said it up until now, he said it because you've made it difficult. It's not right that he's got a new girlfriend, that he's gone on to a new life, that you don't have a new life, that you don't have a new life. All of those things are very unfair, that you're living with your sister, that you no longer have a home for your children. I read your answer.
We have a beautiful home. We have a beautiful new home, and we are very happy.
Well, you want me to read your answer? You want me to read your answer?
Sure. Yeah.
Fine. I'm going to read what you said. Then if what you said is a lie.
So she's a bum who lives with her sister, and she's trying to keep these kids from their dad.
You said, because of Chris, I don't have a place to raise my children. My sister has taken us in on a temporary basis. That's what you swore to in your answer.
Yeah, but it's a beautiful home.
Ms. Rizzo, I said all that's necessary to you. Put your hand down. You have to know that this has nothing to do with you. You're extra. You're fodder. This has nothing to do with you.
And this is why no one should date people who have kids. Man or woman. At this point, but men especially don't date the people who have kids, because it's none of your damn business.
You have nothing to do with his children. You have nothing to do with his former life. This has nothing to do with you. Do you understand?
Yes, Your Honor.
Perfect. I wouldn't give up so easily on visiting with my children.
I have no plan on.
I wouldn't give up so easily, but I'm telling you, I did my best.
So guys, pulling this here, And, you know, Judge Judy, you know, she has some pretty good clips where she is advocating for men and fathers. And yeah, it's just good to see that this is actually on daytime TV. So that is a shock. All right, you guys, let me know what you think. This is AJ. I'm out of here.